Hello the kids, it is I, Stray Cat, the one and only, coming with another episode of Fallout 4. Alright, when we left off, we had Nikki in this little bubble here, mainly to try and be part of the Memory Den's little setup here. And we're going to travel into, well, for lack of a better phrase, travel into Kellogg's memories. See where everything went wrong. Nice. But we have a little thing here I wanted to pick up first. Includes the Grogneck the Barbarian holotape game. Oh, I don't think I ever picked this up. Alrighty, that's the thing. Anyway, I'm just going to jump into here if Kate will politely get out of my way. But then Kate and politely, weirdly, not in the same sentence. Not that often. Okay. Please stand by. I guess I'm going to be looking at this for a while. Brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Okay. Activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. Okay. Load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on. Okay. It's not comforting. Okay. Bright white light. Am I dead? This is what being dead is like, right? Well, I mean, Kellogg's dead, so...
Can you hear
me? Of course I could see this.
Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working.
Okay.
The memories are quite fragmentary.
What the hell am I sitting on?
Through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
Okay. Oh, so I can walk on these. All right.
There.
Oh,
this
all right.
This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
The earliest intact memory. Okay, we'll keep that in mind. These are flashing weirdly. But then again, this is supposed to be like the brain synapses, right? So this makes sense.
Remember, you are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Okay.
Turn down the goddamn radio! I'm trying to sleep!
Dad
okay.
Drunk or not around? I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
Okay.
People always hoping for something better. They usually end up with something worse.
That's true. I'm gonna keep myself down a little bit. Oh, I guess this is Mom.
Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but, she loved me, in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then.
Fair enough.
What's it mean, Mom?
Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
Connie.
Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like, before the big war.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though.
Don't you listen to
Sheesh.
That battle. I'm going to stop singing you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough.
Oh.
You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless, but you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio. All useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy. This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
You don't say.
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence.
There. Okay. Alright, so it's...
Try that one.
Well, I'll try it, but... Well, I'll try to keep the analysis of, well, things with Kellogg. Okay, I'm still stuck here? Alright. I'll have to walk then... To keep from them repeating. That's the first I've seen of that. Anyway, I'll try to keep the analysis of Kellogg's character from the end of each little select memory. Because I feel that doing it in the middle of it will, you know, kind of muddy down the water of the memory itself. Does not sound like he had a very good childhood, but then again, in the wasteland, how could you? Apparently he was getting very conflicting messages from, what he was being taught in school, or whatever sort of schooling they could muster up back then, and his own parents, which makes sense if his father really was part of the Raider gangs, that his mother would be teaching him that, and from the sound of it, he was kind of expected to defend his mom from his dad, which is unfortunate that he ran away instead of doing that. The guilt from that probably helped a little bit in developing him as a person. Helped is not the right word, I guess. More of hindered. But I digress. Let's move on to the next memory. Yeah. Okay, every time I get close to that memory, it'll just keep saying that, I guess. Alrighty. What is this?
It's gonna be fine. You'll see.
Oh!
But we don't know anybody here.
Kellogg when he had hair.
Maybe?
Come on, Sarah. You gotta give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days. The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand. That's what happiness felt like.
I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just...
I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer.
Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
Yeah, I know. But that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got her.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Alrighty. Well, okay. He had a family. Well, as good a family as he can have in the, you know, post-apocalypse. But he apparently seemed happy. You know, happy as you can be while you're trying to focus on the future. And that can cloud your judgment in that sort of regard. Had a, I assume, wife that could have been girlfriend. I don't know. It's probably a wife. It's 1950s, so some of that conservative value is still in there. Had a daughter. And from the look of it, he still had the gun that his mother gave him. Altered up a little bit from when he was given it to, from there to there. From that point to his adulthood, I guess. He was trying his best to, make it, you know, comfortable living for him and them. But from the sound of it, things didn't go well. That was alluded to with all of them. Something about her not living longer because she was with him. So we'll find out what he meant by that in just a moment, I assume. This looks like a corridor, so yep, this is a, it's gonna be a thing.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you?
That doesn't sound good.
Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you,
I found another memory to try
to help them.
I'll connect you.
Okay. So he looks like he's carrying a different gun than he carries now. The voice said they died like dogs. I'm going to assume that meant, I'm going to assume that meant Mary and his wife. I didn't catch her name. He apparently crossed the wrong people and they, took it out on his family. And of course he got revenge. I don't blame him in the slightest. Still not recent enough to now to show what he actually is right now. I'm mainly saying that because you can see from the way he's armored up, it's not the same as when we fought him. But this definitely shapes the kind of person he's been. That's for sure. And at least it proves that he did understand where we were coming from when we were doing it. And he knew how it was going to end the moment he started that job. He had to have known. Alrighty. And I assume that's him there.
Suit yourself.
Yep, that was right.
There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. They just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end. One way or another.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
If you pay me. Oh, we'll pay you.
I don't remember much from that time. It all kinda blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
That sounds about right.
And you'll do this all by yourself?
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer.
A little bit. His armor's changed up a bit, so he's gone a little more in the metal department than he was leather. But we'll keep moving on. Get on to the next memory. I'm hoping we can get all of this done by the time the episode is supposed to end, but I have no doubt in my mind it'll run over a little bit, so please keep it up. Please keep with me for a little bit. This is to help us understand Kellogg as a character. That said, I didn't really do an analysis there, mainly because most of the accessed memories kind of gave it for us. Seems at this point he's just roaming from town to town doing odd merc jobs because that's really all he knows, and who could blame him? Just trying to make a living where he can, and sometimes having to do the old Geralt routine, killing people who try to cross him. Who can blame him for that either, right? I mean, this sort of hellhole. Okay, on to this one.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
He started to go bald.
You're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed. I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kinda ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't gonna be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
We do, as you can see.
The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute, but I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything. They had the resources I needed, and I had the expertise they needed. Turned into a permanent arrangement, which suited me just fine. I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Getting warmer. Ooh. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. Ah, there's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Alright, but I accidentally triggered this one on my way to try and get more of the shot there, but at this point he's finally met the Institute, and that's mainly because he kept going east, and eventually there's only so far east you can go. And, started fucking with them a little bit. And apparently to a great effect enough that, they noticed him. And he showed his stuff. Became a permanent arrangement. Well, I mean, for him, that's probably a dream come true. good way to get cushy living, and in the same sort of hand, gets to do what he does best, which is not very nice, usually. Alright. Ah. I recognize this. This is when I first met him.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic stasis suspended.
Both computers are still working. That's good.
It was a team.
Hopefully it's all...
Just find it.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
It's about this time he started getting the augments and the different armor set up. It's about here.
I was now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth. If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course, neither did they. Not really. The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me.
Fair enough.
They needed me, and I made sure they knew it.
Who can blame you there?
I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. Guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
That'd be me.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving him alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft pre-war vault dweller, even if he somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If he could take me out, they won't be able to hide from him for long.
Opening.
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. And yeah, I guess it did remind me of her. Yeah, I'm a cold-hearted bastard for sure, but still human. Better this way, though. Better than taking her kid and leaving her alive.
Yeah, because then both of us would have been after you. Making sure I'm not missing anything.
Almost. Everything's gonna be fine.
Come here. Come here.
Wait. No, no. I've got him.
Let the boy go. I'm only gonna tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
Yeah, the animation kind of broke there.
Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have the backup.
And that's about where my memory ends. Anything new there? Whoa.
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Come on. All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Okay. Move on to the next one. So we had to go through that again. But, gave us some extra gleaning on his side of the thing. He didn't want to do half the things he ended up doing, but he knew it was part of the job, and there's not much else he could do. Alright, looks like I'm nearing the end of this one. And, it'll be just about, like, 10 minutes over time, it looks like. Maybe. If hopefully. Is Sean?
Is that your son?
Wasn't my idea to settle down with a kid in the middle of Diamond City.
So, good news, I think.
I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family.
I hit the button too early, that's my bad.
I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long. This whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
Nothing up there.
Kellogg. It's okay.
The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter. Yeah. Stronger and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
One of these days you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this.
Most likely.
Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
Okay, the animation's making them jump around a little bit.
X-688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Bye.
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute, because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there, as soon as you're ready.
All right. Why did the music have to be going? Oh, I'm gonna get a copyright strike. The entire time it had to be going. Of course it did. Okay, let's get out of the fucking memory lounger. Can the music stop? Please. Of course not.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects this procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before.
Oh, I'm sure.
Sims in here.
Oh, did you?
Next time I have to watch someone's life story, I want popcorn.
Well, if you're cognizant enough to joke, I think we can safely say that you're out of critical condition.
Are That's you good.
Ready to talk about what happened in there?
I saw Kellogg's life.
The man who ruined my family. The man I killed.
That's right. He was a human being just like the rest of us. And he had reasons for being what he was. However cruel. How does that make you feel?
It wasn't all his fault. I can't blame him for everything that happened.
If I were a priest, I would say forgiveness is a good thing. We're getting off track. The important thing is that we discovered the Institute's greatest secret, teleportation. The only question is, what do we do now?
What? You don't have a spare teleporter lying around? What kind of egghead are you?
This is serious. No one outside the Institute could dream of making that kind of technology.
Fair enough.
Maybe that's it. That memory about Virgil, their scientist who went rogue. If we found him...
Maybe he might know how to do that.
I like it.
The memory said the Institute tracked him to the glowing sea, but that seems crazy. A madman would think twice about going there.
Well, I mean, this is a guy from the Institute we're talking about. He might as well be a madman for all we know.
If we need to find Virgil, then I'm going after him.
If you're going to go, be prepared. You'll need some way to combat the radiation there. It's called the Glowing Sea for a reason.
Fair enough.
Oh, I'm going in naked. Fingers crossed I get superpowers.
I know you're joking, but as a doctor, I feel obligated to remind you that unprotected radioactive exposure will only kill you. Dead. D-E-A-D.
Okay.
Before you find a way to get through there with your life intact.
I'll try.
And good luck. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first.
Okay.
I removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Fair enough. Now that I've done all of that, and Kate was apparently fucking around with stim packs while she was here. Of course she was. A lot of rat away, a lot of rat X. I'm going to pick all this up if I'm allowed. I am, it looks like. Then it goes red after I take it, so that's really weird. That's really friggin' weird. It's a little jarring to see. Anyway, I'm going to end the episode here for right now because we're already well over time. Holy shit, that was a lot of stuff to have to go through all at once, but it definitely gives us a better gleaning into Kellogg's character, and Kellogg is a bad guy, but a bad guy because of the circumstances he was thrown into, not because he was brought up that way. I mean, he kind of was brought up that way, just a little less intentionally, if you understand my meaning. And I can't really hold that against him, personally. Anyway, gonna end the episode here for right now. Thank you all so much for watching. Click the subscribe button if you like these videos and you want to see more, and click the like button if you like this particular video. And share in the comments so we can bring more people into this community. We can talk about the games we're playing together, and I will see y'all in the next episode. This has been the one and only Stray Cat, playing games and going through the memories of a man I killed because he had killed my... at least the majority of my family, and finding out he's not as much of an evil bastard as I thought he was, although he is still pretty bad for you.